Here's Monte Unis, and that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
You know, that's been a big part of their offense in the early stages. I mean, their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range right at the rim.
And I would continue to do it. You know, force the defense to maybe send a double team. Now you've got other options to work with offensively.
And the Rockets with possession here after the missed three from Black. Brewer's shot is off.
I'll tell you what, the mid-range shot is not the easiest one to make. But when you've got day like he had there, I mean, those are shots you want to make.
Gibson dishes to Snell. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Gibson inside. And a strong finish with two hands.
Watch out below. Get out of his way now.
No way that it...
Make your threes.
Heinrichs checked in. And so here is Houston. Brewer with the ball. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Going with an almost entirely new group here. Joakim Noah, he's checked in for Gasol. McDermott comes in for Taj Gibson. Butler, he's checked in for Tony Snell. And Silks is subbed in for Kirk Heinrich. Glenn in at shooting guard. Noah is out there with McDermott. Then there's Derrick Rose. And it's Butler in at the three. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Now here's Ariza. He's coming off a 10-point game against Golden State. Ball stolen. Here's Rose, and it's rejected. The Rockets trail. Doubled by Black. Brewer, the pass to Kanan. Dishes it to Howard. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
You know, for a player with his explosiveness, that was ATM time. Cash, money, the easy way.
Yeah, that kind of defense is not going to cut it against him.
Cash, money. I like that, Clark.
Here's Silk. 12 points for him. Makes good on the step-back jumper. Silk's got the lead up to two now for the Bulls.
And he should thank the defense for those 2 points, really. Nobody paid him any mind there.
Here's Brewer. No good. Great defense that time from Noah.
Pretty good defense there. I mean, that's a shot that he can make, but they really challenged him.
Back the pass to Butler. Fires the three. And Jones pulls it down. Jones has got rebound number 5 here tonight.
He's trying to shoot his way out of it, guys. And as long as they're in the lead, he's going to continue to try to find his rhythm.
Here's Brewer. And that comes off the assist by Dwight Howard. Brewer's got the game tied up here for the Rockets.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, 4 of their last 5 baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
Here's Silk. 14 points for him. Back to Rose. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The shot. And it's off the back rim. No good.
Well, I tell you what, that's too good a look to pass up there. Even though it didn't go, that's one you got to take.
Here's Kanan. He's covered by Rose. The basket by Kanan. Kanan's got 12.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Bulls making a switch here. Checked in.
And now a look at Isaiah Kanan. How his last 10 games have gone. He's getting around 8 points per game, 7 assists, and 4 rebounds. And he's been passing the ball like a virtuoso. That's what really stands out to me about his recent performance.
Well, you think about his intelligence, the court vision, both are outstanding. Those numbers are hardly a shock, as excellent as they are.
Let's check out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, guys, Silk in the last outing against the Nets got down to business. He finished with 42 points, and he was his usual self on the defensive end, providing a bunch of steals. Absolutely amazing numbers from him in what was truly a memorable performance for him and for us, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris, for revisiting what was an astounding performance, Clark.
It clearly was one of those games that when we look back on his career, this game will be right there among the best ever that he's played.
Well, he was in the zone from the outset. It was just one of those games where everything was going his way, and he attacked, and that's what I like. Once he knew it was his night, he just attacked relentlessly.
And Silk gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. And it's the Rockets with the ball. And Jones has it in the corner. Butler with the steal.
It's good to swing the ball, but you got to be careful going cross court.
They get it back. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give them two chances at the free throw line here. Houston shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
This season has not been kind to them at the free throw line. Guys, they're only making about 71%.
And guys, that allows their opponents to play very aggressive defense if they choose to, knowing it's not a bad thing to send them to the foul line.
Pass to Black. Into Noah. It's deflected. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam. There it is, guys. That Olay defense. Just watching him go Clark right by.
I think we might be seeing which team is ready to take control of this game.
Yeah, that's a dunk that could absolutely get them going. I agree, Clark.
Reverse that one. Oh, now that was nice. Real nice.
The agility on this ball.
Yeah, you love that body control.
Oof. Oh, that one had it all, guys. Power and grace. Just beautiful.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
Out of bounds, Rockets ball as Houston keeps possession. Taking high percentage shots has been this group's specialty. On your screen now are this month's field goal percentage leaders. Second, Terrence Jones. Fourth, Derrick Rose.
Well, they've both had a fantastic run of late. They found a nice rhythm and flow. And the coaching staff has noticed and the coaches have been calling plays for these guys to take advantage of their hot shooting.
And he's shaking off a poor first quarter shooting effort. He's really starting to turn it on now, guys.
Houston shooting their fifth free throw of the game here.
Tremendous output from Howard. 12 points and also a blocked shot. It's been a really complete performance for him today.
No question, he's made an impact just about everywhere on the court.
Here's the dish to McDermott. And it's Moore penetrating. Shot denied.
That's a battle they haven't been winning today, guys. Their work on the glass has to improve.
And that's not the only thing that's gone against them.
Here's Kanan. They lead by six, their biggest margin. And that one's good.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Yeah, he got waxed. Shouldn't be much debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
Chicago shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. And he makes the first. Pau Gasol has checked in for the Bulls. Gibson comes in for McDermott. And so Butler nails both of them.
You know, he's as close to a sure thing as you can possibly have when he steps to the line.
And Ariza with the stuff. Well, Clark, a clear lane to the basket and the emphatic jam.
And that is outstanding attacking basketball.
Well, he had no choice but to take that one to the bucket.
He's been anything but his usual self this quarter. It's actually been ugly to see.
Deflects the pass, and Brewer kicks to Kanan. And Silk gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And another foul would give him three before the half, something to keep our eyes on.
Ariza has the open look. Here's Monte Yunus. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, the numbers since the All-Star break, here's how Chicago ranks league-wide. First in shooting percentage, first in three-point field goal percentage. And they're number two shooting from the stripe. I'd say they've taken advantage of the charity at the free throw line.
And the shooting is really what stands out to me. This is a team that does such a good job of finding open looks. They're unselfish. They work offensively to create good shots. And when they do that, they're on their game. They're tough to beat.
Here's Kanan. The Bulls getting the bucket. Last break. Here comes Chicago. Here's Moore. Buries it down low. And now just a five-point Rocket lead.
Beautiful possession. They found the open man.
It's tipped. Here's Black. It's down the breakaway slam.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Yeah, it's one thing to create a turnover, but to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, that's even better.
And so it's Houston with it. The Bulls getting the bucket. Giannis's shot is good. And Chicago has possession. We've got 1:55 left in the second quarter. No good from Black.
Boy, they're trailing in this game, and they're starting to settle for jumpers offensively.
Well, that's fine, but you can't really count on those to go. I think they should be fighting their way inside for higher percentage looks. Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Over to the wing. Moore dishes to Gasol. The pass to Black. It's rebounded by Houston.
That's kind of a shocker. The defense was there, but it wasn't right in his face. Kind of out of character for him to miss those.
Here's Kanan. 9 points last game out. Shot clock at 6. Let's the 3 fly. Shot no good.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those 2 in the first quarter.
Left side, Butler. There's the 3. That's good. Butler's got 5 points now this quarter.
You might not think of him as a laser 3-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
And here come the Bulls again. Chicago with the fast break.
Oh, get it! Oh, what the hell now? Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, it's startling that he'd even try that right now.
Out of bounds, Rockets ball as Houston keeps possession. Some changes for Chicago. Tony Snell's checked in for Butler. And it's Heinrich in for Moore. Houston also making some changes. Capela checked in for Jones. And James Harden subbed in for Trevor Ariza. Now, here's Monta Ellis. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Golden State.
Boy, he had it going offensively, just living at the line.
Bulls trail by 4. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. No good from Black.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
Cannon, the pass to Harden. Releases. Second shot opportunity. Capela with the bucket. And the Rockets lead by 6.
Boy, where was the box out? Too easy on that second chance opportunity.
Yeah, no box out is what happened there. Those kind of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
And that does it for the first half of play. Rockets lead by...
Well, the offense has obviously been a struggle. What do you think you can do better to make up ground on them?
All right, guys, I want to go over some things before we get back out there. The first thing is that our ball...
those steals.
I'll say, I mean, defensively, he's fought his way through this game beautifully. They haven't gotten away with any loose passes, any sloppy ball handling when he's in the vicinity.
Getting underway in the second half. Here's the 5 for Kevin McHale. Terrence Jones is down low with Harden. Harden and Ariza out on the perimeter, and it's Cannon in at the point.
Getting results, too.
It's a great formula.